The aftermath of every social revolution brings about change. Cultural norms and landmarks shift as our mind beyond the familiar. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose in the land of the living. This is our time to renew, revive, and restore the hope lost to the busyness of life. This is our time to dig again and rebuild from the storms of our past on a solid footing that holds. Welcome to The Foundation.
The Foundation. Foundation.
Foundation. 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant in your company, The Foundation, live and in full effect, downtown Nassau. It kind of cooled down right now. Got a shout out to all my good, decent people. This is a different course of time, a different layout in what we do. December 4th, as you're supposed to be able to spike your eggnog and get yourself ready to jam. My God, you're out here throwing the mace out the window, the thing going crazy. I don't know where you are. If you're in Nassau, show up today. The thing live and in full effect. All the F&Ms out here, you don't know if it's Christmas, you don't know if it's a rally. It's too much. We out here live and in full effect, ladies and gentlemen. Please, show up today. We're going to be able to jam. There is so much going on. The Commissioner of Police has resigned today. We're going to be talking about that right here on 96.9 FM Radio. I am excited. I don't know why. This is Christmas season. My birthday just gone. My God, this is a birthday gift. This is too much. Come down here and check this out. We're here. We're going to be talking about this today. I want you guys to be able to tune in. It's red. See, I know all these people. I see a Grand Bahama contingent of F&Ms here. I see all the F&Ms here. I know these people. Jesus, I had on my red shirt. I had to go change. It was too much. I want to be able to do this, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Garth Roseboro, being able to jam with us. God, say good afternoon to the people.
Yeah, well, Howard Grant, the last time we saw this type of situation is in the Bible, in the book of Exodus, when they had the Red Sea crossing. So I don't know if this is a prophecy, if this is a sign, but you got to join us today on the show. This is Foundation with Howard Grant, 96.9 FM, downtown Nassau, Rawson Square. If you're going to be a part of the show, you call in, or if you want to come down here and speak with Howard, we're right here next to Scotiabank, and he is now broadcasting live for you to enjoy this particular moment in history.
Well, you know, this is a peculiar moment in history. At the beginning of the day, we actually started to have a conversation. Garth and I hadn't sit together for about a week. I took some time off, went off to the States, enjoyed my birthday, did a couple of things, came back to be able to find this out. Whilst I was in the United States of America, we would have been able to see from Clayton Fernandez and beyond that, the allegations that existed in this particular space about what happened at the top rank of the Royal Bahamas Police Force. It was disturbing. It was disgusting. It was absolutely diabolical for the reputation of the Bahamas. And we need to do something about this. So I took my time. I didn't ingest any information from anyone. I didn't want to listen to anyone else's opinion. I read the information and I came on Tuesday and I had to condemn the chief of police being able to take this particular time. I had to condemn him. You know why? Because the fact of the matter is, if we're going to be very clear about this, it seemed like a written response, polished. I want to say this. I want to be decent as I say this. From the office of the prime minister, it didn't seem like something that came out, that emulated out of the Royal Bahamas Police Force. And as I listened to this, I couldn't make a determination as to where we were, as to whether or not this was theatrics. If you looked at it, it was poorly edited. I looked at this entire thing. I said, who are you delivering this to the Bahamian people? Suddenly, shift. There was an expectation for change. This morning, the chief of police, with the autonomy attached, in his position, resigned. Now, you know this was no regular resignation. This was a request for resignation. Talk to me.
Well, you know, the last time the Bahamian people had this type of concern was during the pandemic and the lockdown. Remember now, it was this very same enforcement, the police force, our Royal Bahamas Police Force, the good men and women of the Royal Bahamas Police Force that ensured that everyone stayed in their homes at the times of curfew. Everyone had to be home. And we saw a discipline that we were not accustomed to, where we had to be home no matter what our circumstances were. If we had to go to the water pump to get water for our houses, This is the same police force that ensured that the spread of COVID did not come nigh unto us. And even now, Michael Pintard is coming through the crowd. There's Shannon Dawn Cartwright. How would you want to let the people know what you're seeing right now?
Ladies and gentlemen, right here in the middle of everything and the thick of what's happening right now, we can see shouting Michael Pintard being escorted through. We're seeing the members of parliament. We see Adrian Gibson. All these particular persons are out here, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know where you are, but we want you to get out here right now to be able to talk about this. Adrian White. Adrian! Let me talk to Adrian. Let me see if I can get him. Adrian! Adrian! Adrian, ladies and gentlemen, we got Adrian right here with us right now. Shirt tucked out of his pants. We can see that he's holding the Bahamas flag, being able to wave that in camaraderie and very clear understanding that we stand Bahamas first. Talk to me about your ordeal.
My life has changed as a result of that ordeal. I've been an attorney for over 20 years, elected member of parliament for over 3 years. I was hustled down two stairwells, no idea if they were going to throw me or not, slammed into a wall. I had to use my forearm to protect myself against being slammed into the receptionist's glass. I was thrown down the stairs, lifted into a SWAT vehicle. Nobody else was in the vehicle but a SWAT officer at the time. I didn't know where they were going to be taking me. I didn't know why they were doing that. My life has changed as a result of this day-to-day, and I hope it's changed for the better for the Bahamian people.
Talk to me about this. Why would this happen at this particular time? We watched the video. We watched all these particular things. We saw that sort of a move that Shannon Dawn Cartwright had taken to be able to throw the mace out. I kept watching. I didn't see you. What happened after Shannon Dawn threw it out the window?
I went over to the rest of the khaki officers. I attempted to ensure that they were not going to throw my colleague out of the window. The window is a very large window, and it has a low window sill, so that was all quite possible. My initial concern was for my colleague, including the sergeant that serves us in the House of Assembly. And I did my best to remain civil, but defiant and united with my colleagues and with the Bahamian people.
Adrian White, we want to thank you for your camaraderie. We want to thank you for your commitment to the Bahamian people, nationalists at heart, being able to commit in these particular areas. This is a strong thing that you did.
Thank you, sir.
We want to talk a little bit more about that. I'm going to give you a call next week so we can be able to sit down and talk about it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're out here. We're still having good conversation. We're in the thick of it, in the sea of red, as we continue to be able to walk through. We're going to be able to see if you can grab someone else, right? We're going to have a good conversation. Ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio. Hey, baby, what's up? 96.9 FM radio out here. Let me see if I can be able to get these guys to be able to talk with you in the sea of red today. Ladies and gentlemen, this is good. Let me see if I can grab Shannon Dawn Cartwright to be able to have a good conversation with you. Ladies and gentlemen, we're out here live and in full effect talking about these things. Shannon Dawn Cartwright, talk to me about this. We are live on the foundation right now. Shannon Dawn Cartwright, we saw a courageous attempt to be able to ensure that there was neutrality and an opportunity for the Bahamian people to be able to speak in the House of Assembly. Talk to me about your ordeal today.
Listen, Howard, man, this is not about me. This is not about the FNM. This is about the Bahamian people, and this is about where we are as a country. And what the government and the speaker has been trying to do for the last week is stifle the opinions and the voice of the Bahamian people. As we've been saying up every day, symbolic way to say enough is enough. And we're not going to allow the voices of the Bahamian people to be silenced through the members of parliament, through the leader of the opposition. Enough is enough.
You know, this is not a time to have a conversation from a political standpoint, but you know, this is what we do here on the foundation. Entirely of the political trajectory in this country, and there's an expectation for an uptick and an upswing for the FNM. Talk to me about it.
Listen, the politics will take care of itself. This is about country. Once we are doing right by the Bahamian people, the politics and the election will always take care of itself. But this is not about us. This is about the Bahamian people, to parliament and to the public. The questions that the Bahamian people have relative to the litany of issues that are impacting their lives on a daily basis and the recent revelations that's impacting the reputation of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Shannon Dawn Cartwright, ladies and gentlemen, Shannon, I'm going to call you next week to see if you can be able to sit with us and have a good conversation. How y'all doing, ladies and gentlemen? I show all the candidates out here, ratified or not, they out here today. Who ladies and gentlemen, we're live. Sea of red, jump, Pakisha. Jesus Christ. Oh. What's going on? Ladies and gentlemen, we're out here live in Rawson Square in the sea of red. The only way we can get this to move is if Moses show up. It's too much. Jesus Christ, it's a lot. Gentlemen, come on here. We got to take our first commercial break. 96.9 FM radio. Quick commercial. Be right back after this.
Foundation. Foundation.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
Transform your home for less at Kelly's House and Homes Holiday Paint Sale, Friday, November 1st through Tuesday, December 24th. Enjoy 25% off house and spray paints, plus 20% off paint supplies, excluding net items. Our wide selection of paint colors is the perfect way to bring holiday cheer to your home. You'll also find the best selection of brushes, rollers, and pans, glue, bladders, paint thinner, and more. So catch the holiday spirit and paint up for Christmas at Kelly's House and Homes Holiday Paint Sale.
Standard Services on Shirley Street, your everything Christmas store, has the perfect gifts just for you. Now until December 24th, you can get 5 to 50% off everything in store, plus 20% off Christmas lights, 25% off artificial Christmas trees, Christmas decorations, and all toys. Standard Services, just around the block with everything in stock. They have everything you need to keep everyone happy this Christmas season. Get the perfect gifts, plus 5 to 50% off everything at Standard Services on Shirley Street, your everything Christmas store, on Sunday, December 22nd.
For fast, reliable, and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards. You name it, we can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located at the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio, Howard Grant in your company, in the thick of the thing. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I feel as though that this must be a ribbon on the gift for the Free National Movement right now. I know a lot of persons don't necessarily want to be able to talk about politics, but the truth of the matter, Garth is standing here with me. Garth, where are you going? Garth is here with me, and we're talking politics. We're talking where we are right now. This is what we do here on the foundation. This morning, you can look at my Facebook page. You can be able to see that we had the Free National Movement on my Facebook page this morning, being able to march down to Rawson Square. At the head of the petition was a casket wrapped in the Bahamian flag. And I said to myself, theatrics much? I said to myself, this must be theatrics. A very strong symbol for a representation of a dead government that's not listening to the Bahamian people. I thought it was a lot. I passed through the thing this morning and I said to myself, this is much. And whilst we were ending, then we looked on the House of Assembly Parliament channel on our YouTube, and we saw Shenandoah take a very strong move, a beeline, bam, ran for the mace and threw the thing out the window.
My God. I think the last time we saw that, who was the last person who tried that? That was Cassius Stewart, or was that someone else who tried to handcuff to the...
He wasn't a member.
He wasn't a member?
No, he wasn't a member in the House of Assembly at the time.
And at the time, he attempted...
he stormed the House. It was him and Renwood Wells. It was him and Renwood Wells. I think it was him and Renwood Wells being able to take that. No. Omar Smith. They took a beeline. They stormed the House of Assembly to throw the mace out. But this is from a sitting member of Parliament. And never, the last time we saw this was in 1965.
Yes, with Sir Lyndon himself. So right now, a very historic moment. I mean, right now we're just feeling the energy of the Free National Movement. As Howard said, it's a party that has fully now come alive. The resurrection has taken place. It's people, old people, all color hues of Bahamian people right here at this momentous occasion. People, I do believe that something is amiss. And right now we'll see people that I've never seen before come forward and present themselves at this particular time.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here live and in full effect, and my Grand Bahama contingent is here in Nassau being able to have a quick conversation with us. Darren Cooper, you're here with us. Talk to us about the environment, the atmosphere of what happened this morning after the mace was thrown out, even though this was a designed protest to be able to protest the government of the day. Talk to me about it.
Well, you know, Howard, we came from Grand Bahama to let our voice continue to be heard as Grand Bahamians. One, we've been neglected for so long. We have so much unanswered questions. And so we see this government continues to ignore the cries of the people. And so we came to join the protest today to, one, to ask government to hear our concerns and to also witness history in the making, not expecting what would have happened. But we understand and we've watched the behavior of the speaker, who has continued to silence the voice of the people as a result of the opposition. And so what was done today was a clear indication that we will not sit idly by and allow people who work for us to continue to do as they wish, when they wish. And so we're doing our part. And so I'm grateful to be here from Freeport and to let our voice continue to be heard.
Now, I want to talk to you about this, Darren. Has this shifted the momentum for the Free National Movement? We haven't seen this level of excitement because it's like a frequency. It goes up and it comes down. June 1st is when we saw this level of excitement of this year for the transitioning into a solidified leadership role for Michael Pintard. It was almost like a casket. You put the proverbial nail in the casket of Hubert Alexander Minnis, and now the party had an opportunity to be able to identify themselves, restructure, and move forward. We watched the momentum dip at that particular point. Now we're looking back at it as to the tribulation that exists within the PLP, this administration of the day. We're looking at this and saying, has the Free National Movement found its legs to be able to move on an uptick? Talk to me about it.
Well, Howard, you know, one, Michael Pintard is a young leader who we believe is in touch with the cries and the concerns of young people. And as I've been watching the Free National Movement over the past month, you know, many persons left the party because of a Dr. Hubert Minnis' leadership. One, that we felt that we were not heard, we were not a part of the administration.
You were very vocal in this.
Yes, and so part of over 25 years.
Yes.
And I left the party because I was not prepared then, or am I prepared now to support a Dr. Hubert Minnis' leadership. And so I've returned back to the party because we have a young, vibrant leader, one that's in touch with the ground and one that is hearing the concerns of the people and addressing the concerns of the people. And so I believe that today it sends the clear message that, one, we don't have a weak leader. Two, we have a leader that is fighting for the people and will continue to fight for the people. And so I think Grand Bahama continues to stand with Michael Pintard. I continue to stand with Michael Pintard. And I encourage the Bahamian people to stand with Michael Pintard as we continue to retain leadership and also governance of this party.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's none other than Darren Cooper being able to talk to us all from Grand Bahama, being able to talk to us in that particular state. It seems as though everybody's excited about that. I'm seeing a lot of faces. I'm seeing some people who have been murmured to be moving towards ratification. I'm seeing some faces that have been proverbially gone and distant from the organization. And I'm seeing them renewed, revived, and restored in the organization. Talk to me about it, God.
Just the mere fact that you just spoke with Darren Cooper, to me, that's a revelation. Like I said, there are some members of the Free National Movement who have not been participatory, who are now returning back to the folds of the Free National Movement. I do believe that on this situation, Howard Grant, that the mace has just been thrown out of the window. It landed on the ground here before tourists as well as Bahamians alike. It was restored by, hey, Cousin Brian Brown, it was restored by the Royal Bahamas Police Force and returned back to the house. And so right now you're going to see F&Ms that you've never seen before.
And talking about F&Ms that you haven't seen before or seen in a long while, I hugged my cousin right here. She ain't getting nowhere. She tell me, I got to go. She's right here, ladies and gentlemen. Pakisha Parker, former member of parliament for West Grand Bahama and Bimini, being able to do a good job. Excited in her jeans and everything, protesting on such a momentous historic day. Talk to me about it, Pakisha.
Remarkable. This is something that should have been done a while back, because from the Progressive Liberal Party came into office, they have had no accountability, no transparency. Everything seems to be some secrecy. But the Bahamian people need to be aware of what is happening in our government. And today, as we have done in the past, but even more intensely today, we are saying to them that we are here for you. We will fight on your behalf and we will continue. Today was a remarkable demonstration of such.
Do you think that this is going to light the proverbial fire underneath the FNMs who are indifferent?
It's going to bring a blaze.
A blaze?
Absolutely. Because I know that there are many people out there who are still, to some degree, intimidated by the Progressive Liberal Party. They fear anything that they feel that the Progressive Liberal Party will take. But we will not stand for the intimidation or the victimization. This was just the beginning of what is to come. And if they do not get out of that house, we'll take them out.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pakisha Parker, all the way from West Grand Bahama and Bimini, my good, decent cousin, as she is here and being able to do that. Hey, my brother, listen, we got to talk because I hear some things. All right, talk to me. We're here and I'm seeing a lot of persons I haven't seen for a long time. You know, we're out here. We're in the middle of Rawson Square. You could hear that the crowd is sort of dissipating and moving to one space to another, but we're still here. And my very good friend is in front of me right now. He got on all his vests on. My God, he got his shirt on under the F&M shirt under it, but he got the hazardous vest on because he know, obviously he knows he's going to get into some thick work today. Ladies and gentlemen, none other than Travis Robinson, former member of parliament for Bain and Grantown.
Howard, how are you doing, man? Good to see you. Good to be with you today.
Absolutely. Talk to me about it. How was things today? How did you take it? What was the sort of implication, the indentation into the minds of the Bahamian people? Talk to me about it.
Well, the reality is that the Bahamian people are sick and tired of being sick and tired. And as the opposition, we are responsible for holding the government feet to the fire. And so if we're holding the government feet to the fire, we have to do it on behalf of the Bahamian people. So today was an indication that we will not be muzzled. We will not accept no as an answer. We were sent as opposition to the House of Assembly to speak on behalf of the people. So when the speaker tells the leader of opposition that he cannot speak, that is an indictment on our democracy, that is an indictment on the freedom of speech. So if members of the Progressive Liberal Party can speak in the House of Assembly, so can members of the opposition. This is a democratic country, and each political party, each member of parliament speak on and for the Bahamian people. We will not be muzzled in this season.
Now, if you for the Free National Movement, as you was watching it, as you, had the procession with the casket in the forefront, even the commercials that you played on my show to be able to talk about these things, I didn't know that it would have this particular magnitude and sort of impact on the Bahamian society. Everyone and their ma having a conversation about the fact that the mace has been thrown out of the House of Assembly today. Talk to me about it.
Well, the mace is a symbol of the people. And so what really happened was that the leader of the opposition was on his feet asking the speaker to speak on behalf of the people of Marco City who elected him and to speak on behalf of the Bahamian people. He was being refused to give his presentation in parliament. And so as a result of a back and forth, a standoff, deputy leader took the mace and threw it out the window, because the democracy and the freedom of expression and freedom of speech is for the people. So it goes out the window to the people. We have seen this before. This is not a new movie. We have seen this before. But what is also being seen today is the frustration of many people. People can't pay bills. Inflation is killing people. And it appears as if this administration is tone deaf to the realities of tens of thousands of Bahamians while they travel, and they leave us a gangster paradise. And I say gangster paradise because you got crime under control. You have vigilante justice on our street rampant. And the prime minister is talking nonsense about he is not going to entertain the prospect of hanging. Well, if they're not, if they don't have the cojones to do their job, get out the seat and let someone go in the seat, Michael Pintad, who got the balls enough to get the job done.
I can put you on the spot right now. This is what our expectation was on the minutes. Our expectation was for ministers to have the kahunas to be able to do what he proclaimed he would do. That didn't happen. Despite what happened with the twin pandemics, despite what happened with COVID, despite what happened with those things, the Free National Movement has soundly rejected Hubert Alexander Minnis. Is there an expectation that we could expect anything different from this leader?
Well, the reality is, Howard, the Bahamian people rendered their verdict on the FNM in 2021. We accepted that verdict and worked to rebuild our organization, rebuild our party. We're under new leadership, Michael Clifton Pintard, the next Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. We welcome all to be a part of our organization, but we are concerned about the issues of the Bahamian people. And those issues are real. Rent, cost of living, breadbasket item. The leader has been asking this PLP government over and over, take VAT off of breadbasket items. But they're so arrogant enough, knowing that that is the right thing to do, their arrogance would not allow them to give the Bahamian people any type of relief, simply because it will look as if the opposition asked them to do it. This is bigger than an opposition, bigger than the FNM. This is about the Bahamian people. So whatever it takes, we have got to give the Bahamian people some type of relief. They are traveling up and down countries around the world, drinking champagne and eating caviar. Come on now, right? They're having wine and Chardonnay on the country water and soda budget. We cannot allow this. Bahamian people, right? You have vendors who haven't been paid in months. You have 52-week workers in Abaco and around the country haven't been paid in an entire year. You have water issue and light issue in the Family Islands, Elutra, Abaco, and the list goes on. There are so many issues and problems that this government should be focused on beyond just traveling. They're turning a blind eye. Why? Off in the Prime Minister, new BMW paid for by the Bahamian people. They couldn't give two hoops about whether we live or die because they are enjoying a free life off of us. Enough is enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Robertson, all the way, former member of parliament. I'm sure that he has aspirations. I could still be able to hear the fire at the bottom of his voice as he continued to be able to talk about these things. And you know, as we walk around and be able to identify these things, thank you, man, Travis. I appreciate you, man. All right, as we continue to be able to talk about these things, I got to laugh. It's too much things happening on here at the same time. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to be able to come out here and talk with me. Now, I saw someone that I haven't seen in a while, right? I said to him, I see you. I yelled at him from afar. I said, Richard, wear your red shirt. Richard out here in his colorful shirt, but he's out here to be able to identify these things. Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Johnson, you've known him as an advocate, an activist to be able to identify these things. And I want to be very clear with you. Richard Johnson has taken on this kind of a position. You know that he's been very vocal of being able to separate himself from the Free National Movement. Today, the tenacity of Michael Pintard in conjunction with his deputy leader, Shannon him stands in conjunction with this march, in conjunction with everything that's done, and the mace thrown out the window. What say ye as it relates to the straight? I see a laugh, and I know you know. What say ye? Now, listen, Mr. Government Radio, this ain't no podcast. Talk to me about it.
You know, well, listen, at the end of the day, what they did for them, for their party, I mean, it's good for them. If it's good for their democracy, that's fine with me. I don't subscribe to nothing they do. I don't support them. And I don't believe in... An officer was hurt today. A police officer was hurt today. And a police officer who was one of my friends. And I believe at the end of the day, the fact that an officer was hurt, that struck home for me. There's ways that we could deal with things. There's something called peaceful demonstration. Of course, the opposition has a job to do. And they have to act on behalf of the people who send them there. And so, if
you consider this open?
Well, it's unprecedented. I believe the FNM today, the deputy leader, should be proud. And I've always been saying the deputy leader of the FNM has been very silent in his ability to lead. And I think the FNM, if they listen to me, they'll be smart to look at Shannon O'Carter, right, to lead their party.
Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Johnson, we're down here in the middle of Rosser Square being able to have a very good time, one of my very good friends. Listen, man, I ain't seen you in a little while. Ladies and gentlemen, Lincoln Deal is here with us. Say good afternoon to the people out there.
Good afternoon, Bahamian people. How are you?
Talk to me about what's happened today. I want to be able to get a sort of a collective approach of all these sort of input and, you know, how you digested. What has happened today with the Free National Movement being able to go with the protests and then it evolved into this? Talk to me.
Today was, I mean, a lot was going on, Howard, right? So I was here from early this morning, 8, 9 a.m. when, you know, it began, right? So we saw lots of FNMs come out in strong support to protest today. We walked from East Street and you know, Blue Hill Road, and persons came from multiple angles. What happened in the House of Assembly, I think, was historic. Obviously, we've seen it with Milo Butler and Lyndon Pinden, but seeing the deputy leader stand up to what seemed to have been a obstruction of justice, being able to allow the opposition to speak. It happened last week. It happened in the House today. And I believe that what you saw today was just a level of frustration from the leadership of the FNM. And, you know, they had to react.
What's the expectation for the Free National Movement from this point? What are you going to do in terms of being able to capture this momentum? The last time we had a conversation was on June 1st. The momentum was high. It took a significant dip since then. We haven't seen persons coming out. We've heard from the chairman. We've heard from these particular persons being able to talk about it. How do you now capture and move forward?
Howard, you know, I agree. I believe that this is a pivotal and turning point for the Free National Movement. I believe that the leadership is committed to ensuring that we build on this momentum, but also continue to stand up for Bahamians, because it's not just about the FNM. I think what is being done is ultimately for the Bahamian people. I think that Bahamians are frustrated, Bahamians are tired, and they want to see action. They want to see tangible things happen, and they want to see a opposition that is holding the government to the fire. And so I believe that the leadership of the FNM will continue from this point on to be even more intentional about holding the government to the fire. And, you know, I think this is just the beginning of a very long and interesting road.
I like that, ladies and gentlemen, none other than Lincoln Deal being able to talk to us. Lincoln still hasn't talked to me yet about which constituency he's looking at. He laughed. He didn't say nothing on that. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Madam Lincoln. I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. All right? Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with Garth. We're seeing Miles Lerodo being able to walk into the House of Assembly right now amidst a sea of red, looking left, looking right, being very cautious as he takes those steps and being able to do those things. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here in the middle of Rawson Square. We can see Keith Bell here also being able to talk about these things. Garth, what say you?
Well, I'll say this much. I think what really transpired here today is that with all of the tension that this particular government, the Progressive Liberal Party, is now under, that today is what you call the breaking of the camel's back. This is the needle that breaks the camel's back. Now, the question, Howard Grant, is this. You knowing the nature of the Free National Movement, are they truly able to capitalize on this particular momentum? Because we saw this before, Howard Grant. We saw this when they were having convention. We saw a surge of energy that came from the Free National Movement, the base that existed, and then all of a sudden it diminished. Is this something, Howard Grant, that's going to continue to grow? Is this something that's going to continue to fester for this to once again diminish? Is this a consistent royal opposition, or is this just an eventful opposition?
You know, it's a peculiar thing that it happened when it happened. Okay. This is Christmas season. It happened. Okay, so talk to me. So the next step that we take from here is Christmas parties. So, okay, so the Free National Movement will be the talk in all of the gatherings, the events that we go to. FNM, PLP, indifferent. The Free National Movement, Shenandoah Cartwright, will be at the forefront of those conversations around the dinner tables, around the bars, around those particular things. And it will be drawn contrasts between Shenandoah Cartwright and not Cassius, but Lyndon Pinden. Because like I said to you, they weren't members of the House of Assembly. So now we supersede all of that and go back to 1965, and we identify what has happened in this particular space and trying to figure out whether or not we have evolved into a space where there needs to be revolution so we can be able to rebuild from the foundation. Has Shenandoah Cartwright presented himself as one of these particular persons within the Free National Movement to be able to take this, or is this by design? Is this by design? Is this strategic from the Free National Movement standpoint? Because the frustration, it didn't seem as though that it built. Talk to me, let's be very clear. It didn't seem as though that this sort of a frustration that existed within the Free National Movement should have come to head today, but it did. It did. And it did so strategically and specifically at this time. And just before that, we would have been able to see newscasts come out. 6 minutes or so before this happened, we would have seen newscasts come out to indicate that the chief of police, the prime minister, has accepted his resignation. Talk to me. Strategically, I just want to let you know, in the news report, the prime minister has indicated that he's consulted with the royal opposition and indicating that we're going to transition from one to another. I didn't see the name of that person come to the forefront just yet. We're looking for that name. But look at the strategy associated with this. One resignation ain't enough to be able to do the imbalance, because it's imbalance right now. The mace out of the House of Assembly, let's call that 10. Let's call that by points, let's call it 10, just for the purposes of conversation. One resignation from the allegations that continue to be able to swirl around this administration, one resignation outside of Parliament ain't good enough. It ain't good enough. To balance that, you're going to have to shuffle, you're going to have to ask for more resignation, and there's going to have to be some more garden leaves for the PLP to gain their momentum back.
I like that. I knew where you were going with that, you know, Howard. But you got to also remember now that they just denied a PLP general bail. Mr. Bannister, who was the director over at the Clifton Heritage Park, they just denied him bail, and he was shocked and surprised that he wasn't able to even get bail. So it's very apparent that this particular government is doing whatever they have to do to clean up the mess, but it's a huge mess. And I'm saying to you once again that even though you are anticipating and hoping that this Christmas this may be the conversation, I'm not quite certain that Bahamian people have that depth in terms of memory to want to even talk about this during the Christmas time. I think Bahamian people are looking for gifts, they're looking for ham, they're looking for turkey, they're looking to get their bills paid. There's a whole lot of pressure right now on the average Bahamian person. And the reason why I say that to you, Howard Grant, is that based on what has happened here today, would you not have anticipated much more people being here today to witness such an event?
No. No. I just want to be honest with you.
You're being rude.
No, I'm being honest with you. I can't lie to you. I'm not going to lie. I didn't expect this many persons to show up. We see that the Free National Movement has reached out not only to their local contingent within the space of Nassau, but reach out as an organization from a national standpoint to ensure that all tentacles reach all islands, and if you're available and capable of being able to come, come here. I told you I saw a significant contingent from Grand Bahama.
But don't they live here?
No, they don't live here. They live in Grand Bahama.
They flew here today just for this?
They live in Grand Bahama. I know these people from Grand Bahama. They from Grand Bahama.
They wasn't here to shop?
No. They're seeing Black Friday. They're seeing Fort Lauderdale. They'll be in Nassau. This ain't a real Black Friday. The closest you can get to Black Friday in Nassau is a Gray Friday, right? And that's gray clouds because you still got to pay the high prices. But the truth of the matter is that if we look at this and have a very clear conversation, the Free National Movement has rallied its troops.
No.
The Free National Movement members, ladies and gentlemen, I got to take a commercial break.
Just gave me some light, and I want to talk about it.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left, cause I've been blasting it.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News sales representative Kavondre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahama every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Great news! Ron's Electric Motors' new location on Cowpen Road, right next to Island Luck, is open Saturdays and Sundays. So for those needing repairs on electric motors, generators, welding machines, water pumps, battery charges, electric lifts, transformers, and power tools, Ron's Cowpen Road location can have you up and running on weekends. Don't forget, you can still visit Ron's Electric Motors on Wolf Road and Claridge Road, and now Ron's new location on Cowpen Road. Dial 356-0249 or 323-5267.
Then today, Lampkin, the customers love the red suit. You think you can heist them pounds something a little more? We need to see more socks. But before you go, look at, I got some specials going on for the sale. I got two set of 12 by 12 and four set of 18 by 18 tops. Now, the 12 by 12 Al Blanco is just that, Al Blanco. That and the peach and gray Alcala going for $215 a square foot. Now, I got three 18 by 18 flagstone style and a high gloss gray and beige tile for $203 a square foot. For one pin. Sale ends December 21st.
Foundation. The foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio. Howard Grant and your company, just 5 minutes before we take our commercial break. We're sitting here having this kind of a conversation, right? We're sitting here having this conversation and really talking about it. Now, Garth was indifferent with me. I said to him that it seems as though the FNM has all their troops out today. He says, Howard, he doesn't think so. Talk to me about it, Garth.
Okay, here's my issue, Howard Grant. If Grand Bahama is responding to the leadership of the Free National Movement, right now the Free National Movement is led by a Grand Bahamian, Michael C. Pintard. It means then that if Grand Bahama is still supporting the Free National Movement and they're supporting their Grand Bahamian, then I'm asking the question to Howard Grant, where is the Nassau and the other family island support that would have been present here today? You have the obligations, but if Grand Bahama can fly here and support, where are the other people in New Providence who are not occupied at this time, who are not working at this time? Why are they not here if this change is imminent? Once again, I'm saying that I'm not certain that the average Bahamian has been stimulated sufficiently to bring this unstoppable change. I'm saying that I still believe that more work is still left to be done. You cannot take this for granted that because this has occurred, that definitely that the Free National Movement will be the next government of the Bahamas in 2026. It cannot be that simple. So if all of Grand Bahama supported the Free National Movement at this particular time, you still lose the election because you're not seeing the support coming from the other islands. So I'm only asking Howard Grant, where then, if 30 people can fly in from Grand Bahama to support this particular event, then we should have had at least 300 to 3,000 people from Nassau or from the other islands here present today. That's all I'm simply saying. If you're talking about representation for election in 2026.
Yeah, but you have to remember something. The fact of the matter is that there is an economic depression that exists in the Bahamas.
I said that to you.
If the PLP had a protest right now and the tables were turned, you would see roughly the same amount of persons out here. The fact of the matter is that the FNM has a significant hill to climb as it relates to the momentum.
The momentum. If the Progressive Liberal Party that is right now split between two factions, there's the Brave faction, then there's the Christie faction. Presently, the Christie faction has not benefited from this Brave-led administration. However, Brave is wise enough to know to do one thing. Put some feed on the ground and the people are going to show up. The PLP without water, without food, without some type of party paraphernalia, they're going to throw a party when they come to Bay Street. I'm saying to you, if Michael Pintard and Shannon Cartwright had the wherewithal and they had the financial strength, they would have had a party out here today and they would have attracted more people because the people are hungry and the people are looking for opportunity.
I don't know whether or not that assessment for me is accurate. I can't say that. I don't know whether or not that assessment for me is accurate. Okay? We understand that the PLP, as a traditional organization, understands how to be able to touch people. We know that. We know that. Okay? No. I'm not going to fight you. But the truth of the matter is this. The Free National Movement has more than one hill to climb. You know this. Okay. They need to climb the economic hill and they need to regain their momentum. They only can do one thing at a time. Jesus, you only got one mouth at a time. You got to eat one thing at a time.
We're talking about a change today. Is this a position of change today, or is this just simply another event like the convention where
this
we got excited?
This has to be changed, God. The rest of the concrete still on the mace right now.
Man, you can throw the bottle of water. You can throw all the bottled water out of House of Assembly. That ain't going to change nothing.
Bottle of water. They got 2 meters. You can throw one. They got
they
more
got
than that.
They got four.
Okay, so throw one. You still got three more.
Then you got a revolution.
But the mace representation.
No, ain't nobody into that no more. Young people ain't into no mace. Mace is what you spray in someone's face. They ain't into that. The people want money.
Or mace with bad boy. You need to stop. It's too much. Right? It's too much.
Now, if you throw jobs out the window of the House Assembly, then you got something happening. But a mace, you don't want to remember no piece of stick. Stick can't feed nobody.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here. We're talking live. We're having a good conversation. We're going to come back at 1 o'clock. I'm going to see if I can rustle up a couple more persons to be able to have a good conversation with you. We are live. Rawson Square, the tree looks absolutely immaculate. It's beautiful. They need to do something with all these wires swinging all over the place. That is tacky. They can fix that. But it's beautiful out here, ladies and gentlemen. The tourists are passing. They're asking me questions. Excuse me, sir. Can you tell me what's happening today? I say, Biden out the hole. No, we're out here. We're talking good, man. We're informing persons about our democracy. We're informing them about the Westminster system. We're being able to identify a lot of voices and persons who have been disengaged for a very long time and trying to figure out whether or not this is an invitation back into the fold of the Free National Movement, being able to talk about these things. We're going to take this quick commercial break, ladies and gentlemen, get to news, and be right back after this.
Foundation. Foundation. The found. The foundation. 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 The foundation.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news and intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversations. 96.9 FM.
Foundation. Foundation. The foundation.
Ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant in your company, The Foundation. This is, in my lifetime, has to be top five hottest days as it relates to activity from a political standpoint in this week for me. And not just the stereotypical traditional concept and idea associated with what politics is, but this kind of representation of transition, this representation of this frustration that exists within one political organization, and the transition or the potential transition to another organization is palpable. This is rich. Out here, you're going to see all the khakis and whatnot walking in the middle of the street. I assume, because they had him actually covered, the prime minister just hopped into a vehicle and kind of popped out. And so a lot of things are happening right here, right now, and being able to talk about these things. Guys, I don't know where you are, but, you know, I'm always one of these persons where it's one thing to be ascribed into history, and you can be able to read that from a documentation standpoint, from the papers and whatnot. But it's another thing when you can be able to be a part of it, when you can walk and feel the energy in this kind of a space. I know it's dying down right now, but we're here in the middle of Rawson Square. Persons are moving about, like I told you. There are tourists asking, what happened? What's going? Persons, you see all the khaki being able to move towards the House of Assembly, all the recruits, all the new members, everyone, Brian, milk round them out. They're still walking in. They look fresh face, yeah. And being able to do that, this must be a representation to show that unity and strength still exists with the Royal Bahamas Police Force. You know that they have taken a significant blow from even the beginning of this year with the allegations and the speculations, with the relentless kind of conversations in our personal spaces about what the police represents. And then now, with the revelation of what exists in this particular space, it's devastating. It's horrible. And so now, with the resignation of the chief of police, I would like to know whether or not we're going to see any change. I'm sitting here with Garth Roseborough. Garth, talk to me.
Well, Howard, you know, one thing I will recognize quickly is that these very same police officers, whether they are senior police officers or they're junior police officers, they are still our family and our friends, Howard Grant. They go to our churches. Their children go to our schools. These are human beings, but we have never seen such strength today as in such a long time. I think the last time we may have seen something like this was maybe during our celebration of independence. To have so many policemen on the ground, but apparently the Speaker of the House, you want to try to get a Speaker of the House?
Speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, let me see if I can be able to speak to the Speaker. Speaker, we're here. We're here in the Bahamas, ladies and gentlemen, and this is a hot day. Speaker. Well, I guess they won't be able to speak to the police. Tell me, no. So I had to step back, right? So we're here. We're going to be able to find about it and talk about these things. We couldn't get the speaker just now, but I'm sure that she'd be more than happy to come and speak with us on another date. She's headed out, and let's see if some things are going to be able to happen in this place. Did the police tell me no? No, not now. So we can be able to talk back with her.
So Howard Grant, you cannot speak to the Speaker of the House, and neither could Michael Pintard speak to the Speaker of the House. But you should see the crowd, Howard. I mean, people are just surrounding her. You want to get in on that chat, or are you good?
No.
But the Speaker of the House seems somewhat as if she is traumatized. She seems a bit devastated. This is not the strong woman that we've seen in the House of Assembly. She's now having words with an attorney. But she is moving quickly to the western side of Bay Street and not entertaining. Lord Rowe, how you doing? All right.
She's gone, so we won't be able to get her. I'm sure we could be able to get her at another time. See all these persons out here. Things are happening. Things are moving. They had us surrounded. I can't get to her. And I'm sure that she's not down for a conversation right now. So we'll be able to do that. Now, I want to talk about this, and I want to be very clear about this, guys. You know, everything that we've seen from the police standpoint, with the allegations associated with it, the names that came to the forefront, the one thing that I heard is that these men were operating on their own. And I don't know that about police. I don't know that about police. I know that they are creatures of directive.
Yes, sir. Yes.
They have stripped all of their autonomy.
Yes.
And in the event that you decide to be able to stand up again in your own free will, you what they call AWOL. Talk to me about it. How now can these allegations be made to say that these men were working in their own capacity? Talk to me.
If you notice Howard Grant and you, the vehement public, everyone is simply dismissing themselves from the present situation. Everybody's getting free and clear. They're not giving any account. They're distancing themselves from all of these matters. I saw the video myself today as to what transpired in the Noble House of Assembly, and the actions were not noble. You got some PLPs here who are still talking about brave and nothing. That's a quintet. A quintet is five people in one group, but you got five of them making a whole lot of noise. The bishop is walking by, the pastor from Yamacross Zion. I will let Howard talk to you. You can tell Howard, what's the spiritual significance of what happened here today? Is there a spiritual significance of what's happening here today?
Well, I always believe that wherever there's adversity, there's a breakthrough for greatness. So this is a great sign of democracy, and that, you know, God is still at move, and God is the one who sets up government. And the good thing about it is that the God hand is upon our prime minister and his cabinet, and we'll continue to trust God and all that he does. Well, I'll say this. I'm a Bahamian, and I have one vote, and I vote for those who I believe that I can, who actually holds fast to biblical truth, and I believe that our leader, the prime minister, God is with him, and he's been chosen to lead this country for this time.
So talk to me about this. You believe that in 2026 there'll be a revival, a restoration, and an opportunity for the PLP to step back once again and be able to two-peat victory at this particular time. Do you think that this is going to happen in that time?
Yes, I believe there's a victory. I mean, the thing about it is that what they're doing for our country, and of course I believe that the stability that has been brought under the governance of the Progressive Liberal Party, I believe that primarily because of what's happening. I mean, persons feel their pinch and all of that, and of course they have a right to express their views, and expressing your views, nothing wrong with that. But at this time, justice is one that not only be done, but it's seen to be done, and we are seeing that unfold every day.
Last question, do you believe, because this is what I said, and I equated it to a balance in the House of Assembly, okay? Now, we see Shannon Dawn Cartwright as a deputy leader of the Free National Movement, the Royal Opposition, throughout the mace in the House of Assembly. Simultaneously, we've seen the resignation of the Chief of Police, Clayton Fernando, being able to do that. Now, the question for me is whether or not there is a balance. Does more have to happen within the PLP to regain, not just for this administration, not just for politics, but for the nation to be able to identify this New Day administration as an administration that's going to transform the country? Does more need to be done? Does more people need to be resigned, to step down, to move aside, to be able to get to productivity and to work at the government? Talk to me about it.
Yes, I believe that there's a time for evaluation, and I think that with the reaction of the people in which they are reacting, you need to just pause and reflect. And of course, there's nothing about reflection, and I believe that the Prime Minister is not oblivious to that. I believe that he will review and see what needs to be done and make whatever alteration that he needs to make with his cabinet.
Thank you, my brother. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to be able to thank you, Bishop, for being able to be here with Bishop Rowe, Glenn Rowe. Okay, so we're talking with this, and just being able to have a very clear conversation. Everything is dissipated. We can see the traffic being able to move through right now.
Matt Aubrey. You're passing by. I'm live, my brother. You're listening to me. You might as well come talk to me. Pull on the side, right?
But Howard, as you talk to Mr. Aubrey, Howard, watch what I'm saying to you again. We just had a situation that was pivotal in the eyes of the Free National Movement. Yes or no? Yes?
In the eyes of the Free National
They
Movement.
Felt like this is now, once again, a stimulus. This
but
is
don't diminish it only to Free National Movement. This is nationwide. And whether or not you are PLP, FNM, or indifferent, this is a significant moment for all of us to be able to reflect, just like Bishop Len Rowe, former member of Parliament, would have been able to say, just like we've been able to identify these things, all of us now have to be able to do internal reflection to make a determination as to whether or not we take the left foot first or the right foot first.
Okay, so here's what I'm saying to you now. 5 minutes ago, there was almost mayhem. There was a whole lot of energy, a whole lot of synergy at this particular place. Tell me what you now see. Has everything gone back to normal? Or is the energy still here? I'm saying to you again that even though this event took place, Howard Grant, do you expect to get the same energy from the people of the Bahamas, from the government of the Bahamas, the Progressive Liberal Party, from the Royal Opposition, the Free National Movement? Will this still be significant on January 2nd of next year, or is Junkanoo going to wash it all away?
Now, 1965, the transition that happened, though it was the very first time, that actually propelled the PLP into formation. It propelled the PLP into governance and self-governance. It propelled the very first black leader and prime minister that we've been able to see in this country. And so all this happened with the momentum that existed not only in the House of Assembly, but from Burma Road. So this actually matriculated throughout decades to be able to find ourselves to independent rule. As a nation that has but 80 to 85% black to 20 to 15% white. So if we identify it like that and make a determination, we with all our smarts and access to what's happening around here, though we ingest all these things and social media and commercialism, the fact of the matter, I believe, is that the momentum will still exist. Now, what you do with that momentum, what you do with that momentum, how you transfer that into growth and development, how you transfer that into being able to find yourself moving forward is, right? So you have to make a determination what you do with that momentum. And the question is whether or not the FNM can be able to capture this momentum and transfer it so it can be able to be a conductor rather than an insulator. Talk to me.
I want to agree with your mindset, but understand I have to disagree in that the movement in 1965, 1966, 1967, I give credibility to the movement in North America, our neighbor to the North, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, all of the hangings, all of the bombings, all of the murders that took place in North America, the killing of the young man in Chicago, all of that came to the Bahamas, and therefore, at that particular time, the throwing away of a mace that belonged to a Caucasian government.
Well, this is a lot what you're doing right now.
Of course, the stick significance is that it belonged to a Caucasian government and was protected by the Caucasian force. Today, we have an African stick, because we got an African-based government. And the truth be told, you Bahamian people, even though there is 700 islands, the respect that we have for Howard Grant, the respect that we have for Brave Davis, the respect that we have for Michael Pintard is not the same respect we have for those who were governing over us in 1966. It's a different type of respect. Therefore, I said to you, the throwing away of that stick is not that significant as it was when it was thrown up by Cylinder Pilling himself. It's just another stick.
I have to disagree with you 100%, because the fact of the matter is that when we identify this, this is not an African government. We are still under the Westminster system. Whilst we talk about self-government, who is in the middle of that? This porcelain statue that exists in this particular space.
In the house, whose face was in there marshalling out the MPs? Whose face was sitting in the seat that is called the seat of the Speaker of the House? Who was there as the leader of the government? It's a different face. It may be the same force. It may be the same energy, but it's a different face. And I'm saying to you once again, for us to become a stronger nation, we have to first give respect where respect is due. Howard Grant is a man. He is a family man. He's a hardworking man. You got to give him some respect. But when you have people who are going to stand up for the people and stand up for the right of the people and be marshaled out as if We are back watching the movie Roots and Kunta Kinte. Man, what do I have to say? It only adds up to disrespect. So I'm saying to you once again that because we don't respect each other sufficiently, what's now going to happen is it was them who got pushed around. It was them who got kicked out of the House of Assembly. I need my ham. I need my turkey. I need my food. I need a job. I need to get my bills paid. I. So I'm saying to you once again that I guarantee you in 2 weeks' time, it's a valley versus valley, a Saxon versus valley, a one family versus valley, and this one versus the roots, and all type of other talk. It ain't going to be this. I promise you it ain't going to be this. And this matters more to our country right now that we unify and become stronger than it is just for a cultural event of John Canoe.
I don't think we should diminish the Bahamian people into things. I think that we are complex enough to understand the necessity of being able to survive. I think we understand the times that we live in. I think we have evolved as a people to understand that we must get something and capture something for ourselves. But I don't think we should be diminished into a people that only thinks in this kind of a rudimentary, foundational survival mode. I think we've evolved beyond that. I think we're educated. I think we are expanded. And I think that we are in a space right now that we can see what's going on. We could see Johnson and the information that came to the forefront from the allegations that's been swirling around what's happening for the Royal Bahamas Police Force. From we've been able to identify those particular things. From we've seen the resignation of the Commissioner of Police. We've seen even the presentation of the Commissioner of Police and how he's been able to do that and how it was choppy and indifferent and very political. We've seen those particular things. We've seen that this administration is being, this is a tug of war. The PLP now, they have to fight for a position. They have to fight for their position. This is just not going to be a walk in the park. The FNM has shown them that today. We have placed them in the position. The FNM has shown them that today. If you're going to talk about the Bahamian people looking at optics, with the casket going down before the Free National Movement, with the mace getting thrown out of the house, those optics can be able to shift the minds of persons who were indifferent whether or not they should support the Free National Movement.
I think the optics don't count only because most Bahamians have access to the Wi-Fi and the internet and the TV. We've seen caskets before. We've seen indifference on television before. Here is what is indifferent. And this is why the electorate is so minimal at this particular time, diminished because no one no longer has confidence that the member of parliament and the prime minister or the police force or any other force in this country has their interests at heart. It almost feels as if it's a doggy dog world. And this is where we are right now.
What do we do at this point?
Well, I've been asking people to get involved, be prepared to vote for something that is different, but ask the average Bahamian if they want what's different. Everyone is just so focused on self that the country continues to stagger, it continues to diminish, we continue to talk about the same issues, and I'm saying to you once again, Howard Grant, that the first party to bless, and use the word bless, like how they say during this Utah, to bless the Bahamian people in a remark way, will be the party that will win the next general election. And I'm not sure the Free National Movement has that blessing in their pocket.
I can't talk like that. I can't talk like that. I can't take that kind of a, I can't take that posture on the Bahamian people. I won't do that. For what we do here on the show, for what we do on the foundation, for our representation of what we mean here, I won't do that to the Bahamian people. I won't diminish you to pocket change. I won't diminish you to a t-shirt. I won't diminish you to those things. I don't know how you view yourself, but I don't view you in that manner. I don't need a t-shirt with a couple dollars in it. I don't need those things. I'm good. I got more t-shirts I could give it away. And we're making money. We give God praise, honor, and glory. The fact of the matter, I can't do that. I can't do that. Now, if there's a government that's actually being able to talk to entrepreneurialism, to talk about capital funding, to talk about ideas and innovation, to being able to move from one space to another, that talks about being able to move from one island and opportunities to be able to move to Grand Bahama or Abaco, and if you build and develop, this is what we're going to give you. If there's a government, the growth and development, then this is the government I want to talk to. But if you're just going to be able to have a conversation with me about this sort of an idea that here's a t-shirt, put on this t-shirt to represent me as I'm a branding tool, the devil is a liar. Lord could keep you a little change. I'd probably take your t-shirt and your money. But the fact of the matter is that we're not going to be able to have those kind of a conversation. All right? So we're going to be able to do that, ladies and gentlemen. Let me take my first commercial break. Take a quick commercial break. I'm going to be right back after this.
Foundation. Foundation.
The Foundation will be back right after this.
The Foundation.
At Wendy's, we are cooling things down with our new Kit Kat Frosty. Try our traditional chocolate or vanilla Frosty topped with classic milk chocolate Kit Kat pieces. Our signature frozen dessert is not an ice cream, it's a Frosty. 100% dairy, that is. Great things happen when two icons meet. Our signature Frosty and a creamy milk chocolate taste of Kit Kat. Available for a limited time only. Restrictions apply. Wendy's, different inside and out.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News sales representative Kavandre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Always on the go? Missed a show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news and intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversations. 96.9 FM.
Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio. Howard Grant and your company, the Foundation, live and in full effect right here in the middle of Rawson Square. Now the traffic is towards the east. So moving from westerly to an easterly fashion, everyone is out here right now. If you're listening to me, honk your horns right now. Let me hear you honk your horns. You already honk your horns? Stop it. So we're here in Rawson Square, being able to see everybody go down, and things have really diminished in this sort of an area, right? Like Garth would indicate, this we've actually been able to see the momentum die down, and he wants to be able to identify this as the momentum that exists within the Free National Movement, that the same momentum that existed today would also die down and nothing will come of it. So we're going to have that kind of a... Now, I have an eyewitness account. She ain't going to give me her name. I ain't going to give her name. But tell me about what happened while you were in the House of Assembly today.
Don't say your name. Go ahead. Tell I am not going to say my name, but I'm just going to say what I saw. And from what I seen, you know, I feel like Mr. Pintach them putting on a skit or some comedy and playing with the Bahamian people emotions, because, you know, the whole speaker clearly was just trying to say, after she is finished going with her protocol, with the order that is on her paper, then she would have get to him and then he would have been able to express what it is that he had to say. You know, Mr. Pintosh was just, he was just so rallied up, and him and his other companion was just rallied up about the situation. And, you know, they it's like they came in there with some evil intentions. But, you know, the Bahamas is a blessed place, and I believe God, and God is covering the people, but you can't see the people, and, you know. But
so you believe that this was a deception?
Well, yes, sir, it was a deception, and, you know, it just didn't work. Even when the fella throwed the, he did it, like, he had all of these things planned in his head. It wasn't something that, you know, was what that he planned right there now.
Spontaneous.
No, that seems like him and them, they, whoever, when they go and they second host meeting, they talked about that, and then they decided to act on it. But like I said, the Bahamian people ain't stupid. Once they watch the Parliament show, then they would see what time it is, you know. But the Bahamas is covered, like I say, God got us.
I appreciate you. That was our anonymous eyewitness being able to talk to us about what's happening in the House of Assembly, giving us, for the very first time that I've heard it in this particular manner, it was like a skit. Oh, Lord, this is a lot. This is a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, we're still out here in Rawson Square being able to talk about these things. Now, Garth has taken on a very strong position today. Garth has taken on a strong position today and indicated that the Bahamian people want things. In so many words, he's indicated that the Bahamian people just want things. I can't ascribe to that. I can't say that this is who we are as a people. I can't say that. It'll be wrong for me to be able to ascribe that and be able to project that on the Bahamian people. I do believe that we're in an economic crunch. I do believe that we're looking for an opportunity to be able to have a piece of property, to be able to feed our children, to expand. I do believe that young persons should be able to have more than one child without shaking in their boots trying to figure out what we're going to do. I do believe that things are happening in this particular manner. However, I cannot believe or say that the Bahamian people are in such a position and being able to identify those things. I cannot believe that the Bahamian people are going to stoop to a position and just merely put their hands out as though they're begging arms, as opposed to being able to fight for what they believe. I cannot believe. I hear what God say, but I can't ascribe that and put that on the Bahamian people. I'd be wrong, because I don't believe I set up the show and do all these particular things.
No, Howard, I think your cause is very noble. I understand exactly what the foundation is all about. I know that you have a heart of gold. You want to inspire people. You want to build families. You want to build nations.
The PLP is a heart of gold. You need to stop. Go ahead.
But listen, Bahamian people, we have to honestly assess our country. Who, Howard, I'm going to ask you, who has brought us to this place where we have seen so many homeless individuals walking the street? They call them vagrants. Where we have seen so many people walking up to you, but you don't see that much people like I do, but asking you for $5 and $10. Who has brought us to this place where the mortgage companies are looking for the average citizen, the average middle-class individual? Who has brought us to this place where people are seeking so much refuge in the United States and Canada and other places? Who has brought us to this place, cost of living? Isn't this not the same House of Assembly? Is this not the same two governments, the PLP and the FNM, back and forth, back and forth? We've both given them their heart, we've given them our lives, we've given them our children, and today we have seen a testament today that we have to ask the question, does the House of Assembly truly work for the Bahamian people, or does it work for the Royal Bahamas Police Force, or does it simply work for the MPs, or does it work for the Royal Opposition? Who is the House of Assembly working for? That is the question that I want to ask.
Well, you know, we got these people talking in the background, being able to talk the way that they are, but don't cuss on the people on the radio, or could I? That's these people in the background. But if we're having a good conversation and really being able to talk about these things, and I just can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't believe that living in this country means that I would have to be able to subject myself and genuflect to an idea of corruption. I can't do it. I can't believe it. I was so very disappointed in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. You have no idea. Jesus God Almighty, you have no idea how disappointed I was when I heard that information. I was, and being able to identify those things. So you did not hear me talk about it until yesterday. But you have no idea. Like Paul Rowell, former commissioner of police, was indicating. Paul Rowell indicated that he heard the information. And when he heard the information, that his heart broke. He felt his heart broke. This is what he said. He said when he got the information with the chief of police, now the former chief of police, Clayton Fernando, he said that his heart broke. And before he said that, I had those exact sentiments. I was so very disappointed. Not only the men and women who we have identified that have gone through courses, that have gone through training, that have been stripped of their autonomy, that have been stripped of their position, to be able to find themselves in a militant mindset and to be doing as they are told in the Royal Bahamas Police Force, in the uniformed branch of our country, has gone AWOL against their objective, against their role, against their commitment, against their oath to take care of the Bahamian people, and now distributing drugs and paraphernalia and so forth and so on, not only within the confines of the Bahamas, but out internationally. This is the most disappointing thing ever. And if heads did not roll, and this is not enough for me, being a position and being able to resign, and hopefully, or more than likely, the Prime Minister has identified an opportunity for him to be, you know, find a nice cushion landing. As he transitioned, there was this is my assessment. There had to have been a conversation had, I want you to move from one space to another. This wasn't just ousted. Talk to me about it. Not that I want the man out in the cold, but I want to talk about these particular things. Everything seems to be a negotiation. Everything seems to be politically charged. There is no commitment to nationalism and growth and development for the Bahamian people. I'm sick and tired of this, man.
And Howard Grant, this is what I've been saying all along. I'm saying to you, who brought us to this place? Everyone else seems to be getting a cushion landing. Everyone else seems to be getting what they desire. They get the positions that they want. They get the pay that they want. The children go to the schools that they want. What about you? Bayman people, I need you to ask yourself one question. What about me? How do you feel as if your country, do you believe that your country is benefiting you to its maximum potential? Do you believe that you can now climb over that glass ceiling, shatter it if you may, and get to the next level? Do you believe the God that you say you serve is going to take you to where you need to be in the promised land, or do you simply believe that God has forgotten our country? Right now, this is embarrassing. Right now, we've gone through turmoil and sleepless nights. But once again, I want to say something to you. As the chief of police is removed from his duty and may find a soft landing, a cushion landing, you who have been fired from your job, you have been dismissed from your job, you have lost your job, can you find a cushion landing? Could you find a soft landing? Let's talk about you. And you stay home and you say, I'm not going to vote anymore. I'm not going to get involved anymore because I have given up. I'm sick and tired of these politicians. I'm in Roseboro today. Please, go and register to vote. I've spoken to Howard Grant. I've spoken to the foundation. I've spoken to you. And I need you to now focus on who is asking to represent you. For me, it doesn't matter whether it's gold. It doesn't matter if it's red. It doesn't matter if it's a third party. The person. You must now take that person in and ask yourself the question through all of the polls that the foundation has done. Who is worthy to represent your constituency? Let us force these parties to select the people that mean you well. To allow a party leader to simply bring his cadre of 39 people. We now see the evidence, Howard Grant, of what a leader does when he chooses his 39. We need to move this country to the point where we force these leaders to choose our 39, therefore we can have proper representation.
Garth, impassioned in this position, being able to talk like he is getting himself geared up and ready to campaign.
I ain't got no seekers. Ain't nobody want God Rose. Right? Too smart. They can't trust me.
You're too smart.
That fellow over there in Miami who was whistleblow, they must say God is a horn blower. I must see a trumpet blower.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking like this, and we're really getting to the meat and potatoes, to the nook and cranny of everything that's happening in this country and being able to identify those things. I'm seeing you guys pass right here in Rawson Square.
Back to normal.
I don't think things will ever be able to shift. The country has shifted, Garth. Garth, the country has shifted. People need to be able to pay for Christmas gifts.
Okay, guess what? You talk about Christmas. You saw a big Christmas tree over there? You know how much money they spent on that one Christmas tree and how many Bahamian people hungry, right? And let me ask you a question. Stand right here and look. How many tourists and how many people see looking at a Christmas tree yet? Nobody looking at that Christmas tree.
I know exactly how much money they spent on it.
You know that.
Right down to the dime.
You get the contract, eh?
No, I didn't get the contract.
I didn't
even bid for the contract, but I saw it. I know. She told me she could do it. She said, I could do it. No, but I wouldn't bother with that. For God's sake. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're down here. We're having a conversation. We're talking about these things and just talking about the state of the nation and the state of how things are happening in the country. We're looking for these particular persons. I was trying to be able to find out if we could squeeze one or two more politicians being able to come out. But everyone is in the House of Assembly right now and being able to talk the way that they are. So I'm always grateful to be able to be here and talk like this and be able to talk to the members of the public and be able to talk to how things are happening out there. I was hoping to be able to grab Michael Pintard before he went through, had an opportunity to be able to speak with Shannon Cartwright, and you heard me speak with Pakisha, Travis, and the other persons being able to do that. But I really wanted to be able to speak with Michael Pintard. I think he's in the House of Assembly right now. I said, let me see if he can hang around to be able to do that. But he's always invited to our space to sit with me and have those kind of a conversation. This is the direction that the country is going in.
Howard Grant, it's just amazing that you just mentioned that, because I've spoken to so many people who want to speak with Michael C. Pintard. And it always seems as if he's very busy. I want to remind him and remind the politicians that your busyness can be your greatest downfall. You have to be available. You have to be inclusive. You have to be humble. You people act so arrogant and so out of touch before you even get to the place and destination that you desire. You are a Grand Bahamian. Let me just put this on the line for you, Howard Grant. You know, and I know, that there has been a... Man, you're a Grand Bahamian too. You, I'm about to tell you what's going on now. One minute. That Grand Bahamians don't stick together. I agree with you. You are Howard Grant. You big name. 8 Mile Rock, West Grand Bahama, Howard Grant in Grand Bahama. When you come to New Providence, Nassau people is a different breed. You're coming from a family island. You're coming from the second city, and you're going to lead the nation. That takes a whole lot, Howard Grant. That takes humility. That takes focus. That takes you becoming available to the people in Nassau so that they can fall in love with you. Nassau people are very suspicious of Grand Bahamian people. You know we always had a riff with you all because we're always jealous of y'all. You all had, what, cable back in the day when we had to go atop our roof and change our antenna. Don't act like you don't know. Y'all were the magic city while we were living over here over the hill. Come on, man. Sir. I'm just saying what it is.
We didn't just have cable. We had satellite too. Let's just be clear. We had satellite too. Okay, Miss Anna, look forward to hearing from you, right? We're here, we're talking like this, man. I don't want to continue to be able to have this kind of a rift that exists between two factions, whether there's an indifference or there's a difference that exists between two political organizations. But for all intents and purposes, we're having a conversation about unifying the country, to be able to find neutrality, to find a space where all of us can find ourselves in the belief of being able to find camaraderie, to find that cohesion for growth and development. We got to be able to charge the atmosphere with that. I'm not going to be one of these doomsayers. I'm not going to be one of these doom and gloomers. I can't do that. I think there's enough space and place for it. I think you got podcasts, you got radios, you got WhatsApp, you got all these things. A person could be able to amplify that themselves. Here on the foundation, I want to be able to take the time out to remind you of your strengths. That's all I want to do. I don't care how you find that, whether or not you think I'm being sentimental, whether or not I'm out of touch. Listen to me. I have to speak those things. I believe in the Bahamas. I believe in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. I believe in your strength. I believe in your conviction. I believe that you wouldn't choose to be a police officer or all them other jobs available unless your mama say, baby, come on, you know the government is paid for sure. Go be a police. I believe in you. I believe that your choice of being able to choose a profession had to come with some conviction. And even if it didn't, at the onset, I believe that you grew to love what you do and understand the authority that you have. I cannot put you in this kind of a position, an idea to say that you're less than and all of y'all corrupt. There are some corrupt apples among you. There are some horrible people among you. There has been speculations and conversations about squads to go do this and do that that continues to be able to run towards my telephone. We never talk about it. We never talk about it. But stop breaking my heart, man. And start proving the naysayers right. You are better than this. And at the beginning, at the onset today, to be a of chief of police, it says to me that more persons should take a garden leave. More persons should take a garden leave. We should see some ministers step down. I care not to say who. Of course, I have it in my mind. We should see ministers step down. We should see cabinet shuffle. We should see persons incorporated in the cabinet, persons taken out. The PLP has a significant amount to do because you're not only trying to prove yourself to the Bahamian people, you got to now prove yourself to our international allies and big brother America that you are committed, because you know these people have been watching. Not only, they've been watching you, man. They've been watching you. They are watching this administration. They've been watching the former administration. They're watching you. And if they could indicate for March 2021, then out, something is going on. Now! They didn't do this in January. They didn't wait till January.
No.
What was 20 more days? The people could wait by 20 more days. The people could wait 20 more days. So the children could get their ham and turkey and gift and smile and this and that. They throw the thing in now. Bam! Why they do it now? Something going on.
Yes, yes, yes. Listen, people. How long has the Bahamian people been watching? That's the question. How long have we been watching? You know something? We've been watching from the Commission of Inquiry back in, that was 1992. We've been watching, we've been observing, and no one paying us no mind. Now, all of a sudden, America paying mind. We all over USA Today. People call me from all over America. Boy, God, you all see the Bahamas in USA Today? But, you know, I had to act like I know nothing. But I shame.
And so,
know who the member of parliament is, the high-ranking political official, whether the Free National Movement or the PLP, step down. Step down. Step out. You shame yourself. You shame your ma. You shame your granddaddy. Everybody who gave you that name. You're a shame to the Bahamian people. You're disgraceful. You need to stop. Let me say this.
The foundation. The Foundation with Howard Grant. We'll be back right after this.
Mind understand more to where I got to get ready for the best of the best of God. I'm coming to the Montague Four Shores from December 5th to December 8th. Join me in Bucktown for thrilling A, B, C, and E class races featuring the top sailors from around about. Mind understand, you want to see me talking?
I'm talking.
Anyway, also experience amazing Bahamian food and vibrant culture with the best delicious local dishes and live performances from the Bahamian top artists. And guess what? I can be there shaking a leg.
Shaking what leg?
And it's staying our shop.
Everything is bigger and better at Burger King Nassau. When you have a big appetite, BK has a royal deal for you. Get a flame-grilled double Big King Jr. or an original chicken sandwich plus four chicken nuggets, small fries, a drink, and a fresh baked cookie for only $9.95, including that. The royal deal was built for a big appetite. And at $9.95, include deal of a deal. Go big and enjoy the BK flavors you love with the $9.95 royal deal at Burger King Nassau.
It's the season of joy, unity, and celebration. Join us on Saturday, December 7th at the Government House grounds for The Inclusion. It's a Christmas holiday fair. Fun for the whole family, Jolly Wonderland Playground, bingo, domino tournaments, carnival games, and even the Santa vs. Grinch boxing match. At 6 p.m., the TNCs kicks off with live DJs like DJ Chris, DJ Humble, and more bringing the vibes. Enjoy native dishes, tree lighting, drama, and live performances celebrating unity in the Bahamas. Admission is free, so come and experience the magic of the season. Inclusion, moving to towards an inclusive Bahamas.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, for the last few minutes of the show. I want to thank you so very kindly for being able to tune in with us. Garth and I were having a very good conversation and being able to talk about that. And one of the things that my good friends walked up, and we're going to be able to talk with them, but one of the things that he actually came and talked about it. Hold on. We can say this. Let's get back in this. We only got 10 minutes so we can talk about this. Now, let's do this. One of the things he said, he says, Howard, this had to have been by design. This is how it seemed. This had to have been by design. Right? And so he asked me, tell him what you asked me. He asked me, Howard, who you think designed it? Talk to me.
Now, we often spoke about the ventriloquist. We also talk about the puppet master, the one behind the scenes. So I called a name to Howard. Howard Grant's response was that the very puppet master that we spoke about is a genius in terms of influence. He says, we're not talking now about influence. Howard says, we're now talking about theatrics. And then the bell went off. I'm going to let Howard explain what bell went off.
Because you talking all these kind of innuendos, ain't nobody want to know that. Tell me, go straight. He said, Howard, this looked like Hubert Ingram did this. I said, Hubert Ingram would never do something like this. So he says, why? I said, Hubert Ingram is a master at being able to craft a contract to get to his objective. He doesn't need to use theatrics. He used a very clear tactic of using his opportunity to be able to craft a contract to say that these are the strategic steps that we're going to take. The fact of the matter is that we've heard it. Our anonymous eyewitness person came to the forefront and said, it seemed like it was a skit. That was too much for me. I say, skit? This is too much for me. Now, I don't want to diminish the FNM's reign or diminish the FNM's position of being able to ensure that they can capture the momentum to shift what's happening out there. But I also want to be genuine. I just want to be genuine.
I want to have a genuine conversation about how things can be able to move forward and be able to stand in conviction. That's it. I don't want to be manipulated. I don't want, and I've talked about this. Yeah. I've talked about this. Even when I have in conversations over the years, 21 years I've been married now, if my wife starts the waterworks, she's trying to manipulate me. I'm not going to be manipulated. That's the police going through, ladies and gentlemen. That's the police going through. I'm not going to be manipulated. And it goes for everything across the board. I prefer transparency. I prefer honesty. I prefer authenticity. And if I could feel that rich and real, then you got a momentum. You got some things happening. But if people are dissecting this to say, I feel like this may have been almost like a skit. Friend, Graham Weatherford is here with us, and also Richard Johnson. Say good afternoon to people quickly.
Yes, Howard, but the wrong name, Cartwright.
Richard Cartwright. Why I call you Richard Johnson? Richard Johnson was on with me earlier. Go ahead.
Yes. Yes, Howard.
And it's because, you know, go ahead.
Yeah. Because here's my take on this. This was something was planned.
You think it was planned?
It was planned. But it didn't go the way I think the planner wanted it to be. Because if you look at what went down in the house, when the deputy leader took the mace and threw it out the window to the public, he now shows leadership skills. Woo! So no matter what you do now, for the rest of the history of the Bahamas, the mace was thrown out of the house by the deputy leader of the FNM, not the leader.
Now you're starting a rift between them and the party. My God, they can't live 2 seconds without you trying to dissect what they have done in the organization. Graham, say something.
Hey, Howard, how you doing? You know, that right there has the appearance of some merit to that, if you really look at it, because the leader should have thrown any mace. You understand? Salinden Penland threw the mace. He didn't let anyone else throw the mace. But I'll leave you with this thought, watching the clock. We have the best perfect distractions in our country. Inflation, hyperinflation, the cost of gas that Americans could never pay $5.50 a gallon for gas, $11 for mayonnaise, food. You can't find somewhere to rent. See, we got some real issues in this country, right? Immigration, it's a list. And we give ourselves these little distractions of, you know, drugs and guns and, oh, that's come down. And then one guy goes into House Assembly and disrupts it. So I got to disrupt it and look even better. But watch, there's a power struggle happening in your party. But I think you come in with that. You come in independent, eh?
Grandma, you had a rare shit talking about my party. You need to stop. You need to stop right now. Ladies and gentlemen, we're out here. I'm being able to have a very good conversation, man. We're talking like this. I like the assessment. I like these particular things. I like these how things are going. On Friday, we're going to have a very rich show to be able to see some more garden leaves. We'll see some more resignations. We'll see a shuffling in the House of Assembly. We'll see something real happening in this country.
Well, Howard Grant, I got a title for the play. The name of this play is Throwing the Mace. Throwing the Mace, written by, and I, when you said the Royal Opposition Leader, he's a playwright, isn't he? Well, he's a playwright. He's a playwright. I think, no, I go on based on what's been given to me today as evidence. It's a bit mischievous, but looking at that Christmas tree, I think we deserve a Christmas play. And I think the Bahamian people got it. But like I said to you before, the curtain is now closed. The show is now over. And as Graham Weatherford just said, we got to go back to work. We got to go find some food. We got to find some gas. We got to pay some bills. We got to find somewhere to live. We can't even go over to Miami like we used to for Christmas no more. And Daddy can't go to Cuba to say his teeth dropping out his mouth no more.
Because he's lying.
Listen, I have enjoyed being here with Howard Grant today. It was a momentous day. Howard Grant is here dressed in black. He is in mourning for our nation, and he simply wants to wear white. And the day that he wears white is the day that he can remarry the Bahamas, and we can have a better, stronger, and more united Bahamas. Howard Grant in black. It was a pleasure being with you today, and we say goodbye from downtown, and have a good one. I give it back to Howard Grant.
I can't even wear my clothes, Jesus. You see these people? Graham, out here looking at me talking about COI, Howard, COI. You need to stop. You need to stop, Graham. I had my red, just got some red and white tennis, my red shirt on. I say, yeah, I feel Christmas. My birthday just gone. I said, come out here, have a good time. I told you, I can't come out here. I'm wearing a red shirt.
So I passed through earlier. And when they said, Howard, you got to go do the show out there, I rush home and put on my black shoes and black shirt. Yeah, because there's a ghost move we're on today. Yeah, there's a ghost move that we're on today. And we needed to hear from the people directly. We needed to hear their hearts, their passions, at the pinnacle of their frustration, galvanized as one, unified in one voice to be able to hear what we're hearing. I got some information indicating that the PLP was supposed to be out here today. That information reached out to them for them to be able to show up, and a very small contingent showed up. Why? A very small contingent of PLP showed up today. We got to find out why. What's happening? Is the PLP now being able to kind of reassess what's going on to shift their position and find themselves moving towards growth and development for the organization? Find themselves really being able to emerge as a new day administration? Is this what's happening now? Talk to me. We want to know more about it. Guys, I want y'all to have a beautiful day, beautiful weekend. I'm going to be able to see y'all tomorrow. Tomorrow is Small Business Thursday. If you want to be able to join us on Small Business Thursday, I would love you to do so. I have maybe one slot available. So give me a call, 827-0111. 827-0111 if you want to be able to tomorrow to talk about what you're doing. And I just want to be very clear with you. It's time for you to be able to advertise your stuff. I think everybody's taking the time out. They're not waiting for January. They're not waiting for the second week in December. They're doing it now. So you too, take the time out to be able to do this now. If you have a business, you want to be able to promote it and to put it out there, I'll be more than happy to help you out, to construct that for you, even with the construction of your commercials. So if you want to do that, I can do that for you. 827-0111. Get yourself prepared and sell those things before they dry rot in your place. Amen. I can't get no amen, Jesus. You trying to present this. This is brand new, miss. They bring this out in 1918. How long you going to have this in here? But this is still good. You buy that, the handle fall off. You don't need to stop. Let's get these things sold. Let's get these things out there. Let's be able to make these things happen. 827-0111. This is the Foundation with Howard Grant. Guys, right here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. We'll see you tomorrow. Godspeed. Have a beautiful day, guys.
The Foundation. The Foundation. Found our foundation.